In this video, you're going to learn how to get detailed data on where your competitors' traffic is coming from. As you know, you can use a tool like Semrush to find where your competitors are getting traffic from when it comes to Google, which keywords they're ranking for, and which pages are ranking for those keywords. But what about other traffic sources like social media, news sites, and blogs? Well, in this video, I'm going to show you how to find those exact traffic sources too. So without further ado, let's get right into the steps. So your first step is to go to the .trends section of Semrush and click on traffic analytics and then enter competitor. And this is going to give you an overview of that site's traffic, basically where they're getting traffic from and which specific sources are getting traffic from, which we're going to go over in this video. So this is kind of like getting a look into your competitor's Google Analytics. It's almost like having a login into their Google Analytics to be able to see where they're getting traffic from. So the first step is to look at traffic channels by type. And this is important because this will give you a high level overview of the channels they're getting traffic from. Not specific sources, but just in general, where they're getting traffic from. So in the case of Backlinko, you can see that the vast majority is this red line for organic search, but a decent amount is direct as well. And this is important because it shows you the potential for getting traffic from these specific sources. So in the case of email, paid social, organic social, it's very low in terms of percentages. Not to say that you couldn't necessarily crush some of these channels, but unless you see a competitor doing well there, it's likely that just maybe it's not a good source for your niche, your business, whatever. In general, if you're looking at a competitor, you want to kind of double down on what's working for them and figure that out. And typically that's usually direct, referral, organic search, whatever it is, you want to find that so you can do it as well. In this case, definitely noteworthy that the site gets so much direct traffic, and that shows that the site is probably a resource that people want to visit regularly, have bookmarked, and don't need necessarily to go through a traffic channel to find it. So that's something I would keep an eye on. Like, for example, something like Semrush probably also has high direct traffic because people go directly to the various tools and whatnot that are available on the platform. They're not necessarily going to social media and then finding Semrush that way. Some people are, obviously, but a good amount are direct, like with Backlinko. So, once you've sort of identified this high level journey, the next step is to look at the sources themselves in this traffic journey feature. So what we want to do is look at this nice visual of where the traffic's coming from and then click view all sources. And this is going to show you all the sources that send the most amount of traffic broken down by channel. So if you want, you can just zero in on one specific source. So organic search, it's typically obviously going to be search engines, and Google is going to be the biggest one for pretty much every website, no matter what niche you're looking at. What's really interesting is looking at the referrals, because this will show you where referral traffic is coming from. What websites are sending this site traffic that's not necessarily a search engine? And these are sites that you can get links from, you can do guest posts on, you can do podcast interviews, maybe you can do a PR campaign if you see that they're getting a lot of news coverage in these from these referrals. This is a gold mine because you can see what's already working in your niche and double down on it and try to get your site in front of the same people. Because if one site in your niche is getting traffic from a specific referral source or multiple referral sources that are sort of have a lot in common, there's no reason you can't as well. So for example, if one of your competitors is getting a ton of referrals from news websites and you notice they ran a PR campaign, there's no reason you can't do the same thing, because obviously there are journalists who are willing to cover sites in your niche because they already are. Without doing this sort of work at looking at this traffic journey and where the referrals are coming from, then it's going to be really hard to know. Another tab that can be really helpful is organic social, because this can show you which social networks are generating the most traffic for that site. And this can also be helpful for saying, okay, this site's getting a ton of traffic from Reddit. Why aren't we doing anything on Reddit? Obviously, there's a community on there that are interested in what we're doing, so we should be there too. Or maybe it's the opposite, where they're not on Reddit and they're on a different network. Why can't we be on there? Finally, the last thing you can do if you really want to drill down into not just where they're getting this traffic from, but why are they getting this traffic, is top pages. This is a great report that I highly recommend taking a look at, because what this does is it shows you where this traffic is ending up. And when you see this, you can kind of figure out what type of content that you should be creating that's going to bring people from other platforms to your website. So in the case of Backlinko, you can see that a good chunk of it is to the homepage, which can accurately identify. And that's just that probably a lot of that direct traffic that we talked about earlier. People are visiting the page directly. But also, this local SEO guide is bringing in a lot of traffic. So if I was, a competitor, I'd be looking at creating something about local SEO because that's clearly working. Same with all of these topics and all of these pages. I would consider covering them as well. And you can also see the trend in terms of how much traffic these pages have brought over time. And you'll notice that recently, this local SEO guide has brought in quite a big bump. Same thing with this piece about Roblox users. and maybe keep an eye on what they're doing. How are they getting this traffic? So, because it's one thing to view the source, but it's another thing to say, where are they landing? Why are people sending them traffic? Why is social media sending them traffic? It's because people are sharing these helpful pieces of content on social media generally. You can also look at which pieces have spiked or trending up, so you can maybe keep an eye on that piece of content and maybe create something similar. So for example, let's look at this trending up piece here, which has brought in a lot more traffic. You can see on a page level how many page views this has got, how it's trended over time, and where the traffic's coming from. In this case, it's a big spike in direct traffic. Organic search is a smaller percentage, direct is big. So this spike likely came as a result of direct traffic, because 80% direct traffic to a page is somewhat rare. Usually it's organic search or another platform, something went viral on social media, you're running paid ads to it or whatever. So this shows that this just has become like a resource that people will bookmark and save, or maybe, you know, it's directly in someone's resources that they keep handy and click on. So either way, it's good intel to have to understand what is trending for that specific site. Again, I really recommend looking at this top pages section, because yes, you do want to look at the sources, but that can only tell you so much, because the source is going to say, here are all the sources sending the traffic, but it doesn't tell you why. And it doesn't tell you what they're creating to deserve and earn that referral traffic or earn that traffic from organic social. And this will tell you by looking at the top pages. This is where all those users are actually ending up. So in this video, you learned how to find where your competitors are getting traffic from outside of just Google. And I'll see you in the next video.